That's straight. Still seems crooked. That's straight. Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. So I told you guys that I would announce when I received my first YouTube paycheck in my other video talking about how long it takes to get monetized on YouTube, the whole monetization process, and really if you wanna learn anything about how to make money on YouTube through ads and how that really works, definitely check out that video first because this video is going to be talking about a bit more of the advanced stuff. But I wanted to let you guys know that I did receive my first YouTube paycheck already. Yeah, I got monetized on July 17th, and I'm gonna talk about how it works, how the payment works, but I made enough money to get paid the first month of being monetized on YouTube. Now, this isn't really going to make much sense because really in July, I had only made $40. Like I said, I got monetized on July 17th, so I only had 2 weeks time to make money on YouTube and I had only made 40 some dollars, but I was able to get paid out on Google AdSense. So I wanna talk about that a little bit, and this is especially going to be kind of talking about how Google AdSense works when it comes to your blog ads and integrating your YouTube ads, because I was very confused at the beginning. So I want to address that for any bloggers that are moving into the YouTube world. So first things first, the way that your payments work is by month. So it takes all of July and you get paid in August, and then it takes all of August and you get paid in September. So it goes month by month. So from July 1st to July 31st would have been my first true pay period. Now I didn't get monetized until July 17th. So that meant that I only had 2 weeks to make money that first month. And in that time, I actually made $44.55 in just those 2 weeks time. Now I am gonna show you guys my analytics. So hold on if you wanna take a look at my analytics, cause I'm gonna show you guys exactly how much money I have made to date and how that compares to per view as well as CPM, cost per thousand views. So in that first 2 weeks, I had made $44.55. Now the reason that I was able to get paid out was because I had already had money saved up. I don't know if you would say saved up, but I had already earned money through my blog that was waiting to hit the payout amount. So you have to make $100 with Google AdSense to get paid out. Otherwise, if you make $98 in a month, you will not actually receive that payment until it gets over that $100 threshold. So going into July, I had already had $64.96 rolled over from the income that was coming in from my blog. Then in July, I had made $23.35 from my blog's income. I had made $44.55 from my YouTube ads, and in total, I ended up getting paid out $116. Now, if you add all that up, it actually equals more than $116, but when you are signing up for Google AdSense and you enter all your tax information, you can decide if you want Google AdSense to withhold some of your tax money and basically reserve it for your taxes. Because when you are making money on your own, no one is taking out your taxes. You have to pay your taxes. So usually, I pay all of my taxes based off the income that I receive, but with Google AdSense, they actually withhold some of my income for taxes. So in total, in July, I ended up making $116 because of Google AdSense, and that was paid out on August 21st. So here's how it works. YouTube ads and blog ads run through Google AdSense. They work month by month. So again, July 1st to July 31st, that is your block period, and then you get paid the 21st of the next month. Now, when I first got monetized on YouTube, I was really confused because I would log into Google AdSense and I wasn't seeing that YouTube revenue. And I learned that you don't actually see that revenue until the next month. So again, the money that I made from July 1st to July 31st didn't end up hitting my ads account until the middle of August. So YouTube says that it will end up switching over to your Google AdSense account in between the 10th and the 14th of the next month. And then you will actually get paid out the 21st of that same month. So if you were looking at your AdSense right now and thinking, I'm not going to get paid out, where's my money? It hits the week before it actually hits your bank account. So if you want to take a look at all of your YouTube ads, how much money you are making on YouTube, you have to do that through the YouTube Creator Studio. Now, if you already have a blog and you've been using Google AdSense and you may be wondering how your Google AdSense is connected to your YouTube account, you can actually go within your settings on the left-hand side, click on account, click on settings, and then click on account information. And within the active products, there should be a YouTube host text text there, and that means that your YouTube account is also set up to your Google AdSense account. Then if you want to see how much money has been switched over from your YouTube account to your AdSense account, you want to go to your payments and then take a look at the pay period that you are referring to. So for me, I was looking at the July pay period. So if I select that, it is going to show me how much money I actually made from YouTube compared to how much money I made from my blog. Now let's talk about how much money I have made from Google AdSense up until this point, because as of right now, it is August 27th and I have already hit the payment threshold for the next month. So I will be getting another paycheck from YouTube this month, and I'm really, really excited. I'm very, very happy with how my ads are doing. Now, if you are a beginner, one of my questions was, how much money do YouTubers make, especially when they first get monetized? And I was lucky that I received my first payment a little bit early, so I made that $40 early, but in reality, I would have just had a bigger payment the next month because it would have rolled over. So far, since I have been monetized on YouTube, I have already made $171. So that is a month and a half of being monetized. I've already made $171 from YouTube ads. Now, since it is not the end of August, I do not know how much I'm going to make in August, but already if I just go up here and I select August, I have made $126.17. And the last payment date that appears on here is actually the 25th. So I still have a couple of days to roll out in August to see how much I'm really going to make this month, but I've already made $126.17. Now, I'm going to change the date range so we can look at all of the money that I have made so far. So from July 17th to, it's actually only triggering the 25th. So we're gonna do August 25th. Click apply. And I want to take a look at how many views equaled the amount of money I made, as well as the watch time equaled the money I made, and then how much my videos are making, CPM, all of that fun stuff. So if you guys want to take a look at your analytics, and you can possibly calculate how much money you would make if your CPM is the same as mine. Now, I'm going to talk about CPM in a little bit. So let's first take a look at the views. So within this time frame, I received 20,587 views, and my watch time was 91,183 minutes. So those numbers equated to $171 in ads revenue. Now, if you take a look at my top videos down here in earnings, the first video is 2 million monthly viewers on Pinterest. That video has already made me $29.31. And that video was actually launched a pretty long time ago. I think it was like 7-8 months ago. I'm not really sure. But so far, since I have been monetized, it has made me almost $30. The next video is my first time driving with Grubhub, which we have talked about that video before. That video has made me almost $20. The next one, how long it takes to get monetized on YouTube. That is actually a recent YouTube video for me, and you can actually see right here, this is when it was launched, and on the day that it launched, it made me $1.40, but total it has already made me $15. And then there is one more video that has already made me over $10, and that is my 2019 Pinterest strategy, which again is a pretty old video for me. It wasn't even shot on this camera, so I know it was definitely shot a couple of months back, but it has made me $11.28. And you can take a look at this. If you want to pause the screen right now, you can take a look and see how much money I have made per view, because it is actually really interesting. If you take a look at these two videos right here, so my first time driving with Grubhub compared to how long it takes to get monetized on YouTube, the view count is actually very similar, as well as the watch time. Actually, the watch time and the view count on how long it takes to get monetized on YouTube is more than the Grubhub video, but yet it made me less. It made me $4 less. Now, this may change over time, but this is because of the CPM. It varies based off of every single video. So let's take a look at that. If you're ever wondering where you can find your CPM, you can actually check it based off of your channel in general, and then you can also check it based off of the video. So we are going to take a look at the videos in a bit, but right now I'm just going to click on revenue up top here, and this is where you can check your CPM. So this is over the last 28 days. Again, I'm going to blow this out so that it includes the appropriate date ranges. And my CPM on average has been $21.25. Now, a CPM means how much you are making per 1,000 views on your videos, and everyone's CPM is different. Even every video's CPM is different, and it changes based off of the location of your audience, what country people are watching your videos from, the topic of your videos, and so much more. So your CPM could be completely different from my CPM, but I am currently making around $21.25 per 1,000 views on my YouTube channel. So if I click on this CPM, you can see that certain days there's a spike. So like on August 1st, my my average CPM was $35, which is good, but you can just kind of hover over this, and obviously the average is around that 21 mark. Now, let's take a look at the CPM on those two videos that I mentioned before. So I want to take a look at that Grubhub video compared to being monetized on YouTube. So I'm going to go over to my video section over here, and I'm going to select this Grubhub video right here, and then I'm going to select this how long it takes to be monetized video. And if you ever want to take a look at the analytics on one specific video, one of the ways that you can go about it is right here within the video section. You can select the video, and then on the left-hand side, there is an analytics option, and then you can take a look at some specific stats for that video. Now, I specifically want to take a look at the revenue, so I'm going to select the revenue tab. Then over here, it says playback based CPM. This is how much you are making per 1,000 views on YouTube. So this video is making on average $17.79 as its CPM. And you can see here that some days it fluctuates. It's really high, like $31 compared to $10. So it really just depends. But on average, this video is making $17 as its CPM. Now, if we take a look at the being monetized on YouTube video, and again, we are going to go to revenue. So within the last 28 days of this video, I have made $12.73, and its CPM on average is $15.86. And again, there are spikes where this day was $38, which is huge, and then this day it was only $3. So your CPM can really fluctuate, but on average, this one is $15 compared to the other one was $17. So that is exactly why the Grubhub video is making me more money, even though it has slightly less views. But one thing that I forgot to show you within my analytics is what type of ad is making me the most money. So if we take a look at this ads type right here, you can see that the skippable video ads, you know, the ones that say you can skip this video in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then you click skip, those are actually making up for 89% of the revenue that I have earned within my ads. So if you go within your settings and you're wondering what ads you should have on your videos, I would definitely recommend that you have these skippable ads on your videos, because that is making the most money for me up until this point. So that is it for this YouTube video. I hope you guys liked it and found it helpful. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel down below. If you guys have any other questions about being monetized on YouTube, how much money I have made off of YouTube, I am happy to help you guys out. So let me know in the comment section down below as well. And I just want to let you guys know that I am sharing this information because I have gotten a lot of interest in it. When I was doing my research before I got monetized on YouTube, I thought my CPM was going to be around $3 to $5, because those were the videos that I was seeing. But based off of my niche and the topic of ads that are getting placed on my videos, my CPM is actually much higher. So if your CPM is lower than mine, just know everyone is different. Every channel is different. So I really hope you guys found this video helpful. Now I'm out of here. Bye, guys.